drives to your system, and each drive consisting various partitions. And today you are going to attach one more additional hard drive, but what you found is that you have already occupied all the available drive letters from A to Z, and now you don't have any drive letter to assign to your newly attached drive. If that is the situation, then you don't need to worry, as Windows already has an option which lets you mount a drive as an empty NTFS folder. If you are a standard user and don't know much about partitioning a hard disk drive, then you can also watch our video about how to partition a hard disk drive. Now let's learn how to mount a drive as NTFS folder. Open disk management either through run command by typing diskmgmt.msc, or if you are using Windows 10, then you can right click on the start menu and then click disk management from the power menu. You can see all the connected hard drives and drive letters assigned to them. Now when you will start creating a new partition on the newly attached drive, and when it will come to the point when you need to assign a drive letter to the partition, you will see that option is already disabled because you have already occupied all the available drive letters. The default selected option will be mounting in the following empty NTFS folder. So what that option does? Mounting a drive as a folder is basically used in two conditions. The first condition that we already mentioned is when you get out of drive letters, and the second is when you have several hard drives, then you might not want to mess up with a huge list of drive letters. As you can see on my computer as an example, it will be very hard for you to find particular data from a large number of drives. At that time, what you can do is you can mount a drive as a folder on any of your current drive. It is just like managing a bunch of files into folders. The same way you will be managing various disk drives as separate folders. So if you go and choose mount in the following NTFS folder instead of assigning a drive letter, then you can browse for the location where you would like to save the content of this hard drive as a folder to another already existing drive. After selecting the location, click the next button. Choose an appropriate file system and click next button, and then click finish to format the drive and ready to be used. Now, as this drive has not been assigned any drive letter, then you can use it as mounted folder just like other ordinary folders to store the information. All the data that you will place in this folder will physically be getting saved on the newly attached hard drive. One interesting thing to note here is check the folder size if you are viewing contents in the detail view. It is a full size 500 GB folder mounted on this drive, and it clearly indicates that the data is getting saved on the new hard drive in the background. If someone intentionally or by mistake deletes this huge size folder, then you don't need to worry at all. Actually, this is just a path and location of the drive where data was getting written. But actually the contents are still saved on the physical drive. If any time this happens, then what you only need to do is reassign the path by right clicking on the drive in disk management and then click change drive letter and paths, and then assign a new path to the drive. And there you have all of your content back in place. Even you can assign a drive letter to this drive instead of mounting it by using the same method. But you must have at least one drive letter available. Now you may have an idea that why this option is called add drive letter or path. So this is how you can organize multiple hard drives on your system by mounting them as NTFS folders if you don't want to assign each drive a separate drive letter. I hope the information in this video will be useful to you. Encourage us to create more videos like this by hitting the thumbs up button and by leaving your comments. Subscribe to our channel to keep in touch. Thanks for watching and keep sharing.